The Emperor Yongzheng lived for 57 years and worked as an emperor for 13 years. During his life, he totally had above 32 recorded imperial women, including two empresses, two imperial noble consorts, four consorts, one noble concubine, six noble lady, eight first-class female attendant, five choice lady, and three 哥哥. The Empress Xiao Jingxian and the imperial noble consort Dun Su were buried with Yongzheng in Tailing. The Empress Xiao Shengxian was buried in Taidongling. Other concubines were buried in consort's tomb of Tailing. The Empress Xiao Jingxian, Wu La Na La Shi, was married with the Emperor Yongzheng before he became the emperor. Yongzheng really loved his wife. In the Palace Museum in Beijing, China, there are a large number of pictures that they cosplayed the average people. Xiao Jing gave birth to Yongzheng's first son, Hong Hui, who died at 8 years old. When Qianlong became the emperor, he posthumously promoted Hong Hui to the Prince Duan of the first rank. In 1731, Xiao Jing passed away at 51. She was the only wife of Yongzheng. The Empress Xiao Shengxian also was known as the Empress Dowager Chongqing. She was Yongzheng's 格格 and didn't be loved by Yongzheng. But she gave birth a great son, Hong Li, who was the Emperor Qianlong. When Yongzheng was alive, Chongqing's highest rank was noble consort. When Qianlong became the emperor, Chongqing, as the biological mother of the emperor, became the empress daughter. She was the happiest and luckiest empress daughter in whole Qing dynasty. In 1777, Chongqing passed away at 84. The imperial noble consort Dun Su, Nian Shi, was Yongzheng's favorite imperial woman. In 1711, Nian Shi was elected by the Emperor Kangxi for Yongzheng as Che Fujin, which was the first rank concubine of the prince. When Yongzheng became the emperor, she was promoted to the noble consort. She totally gave birth 3 boys and 1 girl for Yongzheng. Unfortunately, none of those kids grew up. In late of 1725, noble consort Nian was horribly sick. Yongzheng promoted her to the imperial noble consort. 3 days later, the imperial noble consort passed away. Yongzheng buried her to Tailing. This is the first time in Qing dynasty that the emperor personally decided to bury a consort with the emperor and the empress. The imperial noble consort Chun Yi, Geng Shi, was Yongzheng's 格格. When Yongzheng became the emperor, she was promoted to the noble concubine Yu. 7 years later, she got the consort title. She gave birth to Yongzheng's 5th son. When Qianlong became the emperor, she was promoted to the noble consort. In 1778, Qianlong celebrated her 90th birthday for 3 days and promoted her to the imperial noble consort. In 1785, the imperial noble consort Chun Yi passed away at 97. The consort Qi, Li Shi, was a Han Chinese. She was Yongzheng's first rank concubine. She totally gave birth 3 boys and 1 girl. When Yongzheng became the emperor, she got the title Consort Qi. 1 year later, her son was demoted to the Aries people because of several serious mistakes. This made Consort Qi didn't get further promotion. 2 years after Qianlong became the emperor, she passed away at 62. The consort Qian Liu Shi was Yongzheng's noble concubine, Qian. She gave birth to Yongzheng's 6th son. Qianlong promoted her to the consort. She passed away at 54. The consort Ning Wu Shi was from Han Chinese bordered Yellow Banner. Now there is no record about when she came into the inner court and how she was promoted. She first time appeared in inner court records was in April 1734. At that time, she already was called Consort Ning. The second time she appeared in the records was she passed away in May 1734. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.